Caitlin Collins is out front live at the White House. And Caitlin, you know, this criticism of the president regarding Putin, and Putin frankly telling, seeming to say, hey, I don't know, maybe around when I get to it, I'm not jumping at this invitation, could be hitting home. You have some big breaking news from the White House. They're changing how they handle calls with foreign leaders now.
Aaron, this is big. The White House is no longer going to publish these public summaries of the readouts of the president's calls with foreign leaders. And that brings to an end a common practice, not only in Democratic, but also Republican White Houses that has gone on for some time now, essentially to establish the record that the president did speak with a world leader. They don't often have a lot of news, but they do have a public record of who the president spoke with. We've seen this play out in recent days. The White House not announcing calls that the president had with the president of Turkey and the Prime Minister of Israel. The press found out about those calls through either the foreign media or those foreign governments, and then the White House confirmed them, but did not offer details on what exactly was said during those calls. Now, in the past, they've issued very short summaries of what exactly it was said. They talked about tariffs or trade or Middle East policies. Anything like that can be involved in those calls. That's no longer going to happen. Instead, these readouts will still happen internally, but they will not any longer issue these things to the press as they have done in the past. Now, former administration officials who have served in previous administrations have expressed some concern about this. Number one, saying that it's the White House not being transparent by not publishing these calls. But two, they also lose their opportunity to shape the narrative of what was said during a call with a foreign leader. You'll recall back in April, as there was all this discussion about trade with Canada, and the White House published a very different readout than the Canadians did of the president's call with the Prime Minister Justin Trudeau. Those things are no longer going to happen. Instead, the Canadians will be able to publish their readout, but the White House is not going to do the same. Now, of course, Aaron, all of this comes as there are still questions about what was said during the president's sit-down with the Russian President Vladimir Putin. But now we are learning that the White House is no longer going to be announcing and publishing these public summaries of President Trump's calls with world leaders.
All right. Thank you very much, Caitlin. Obviously, a significant development this evening, as Team Putin says, you know, whenever, when we get around to it for this meeting that you've invited us to in Washington, first in 17 years. Out front now, the top Democrat in the House Judiciary Committee, Congressman Jerry Nadler. And Congressman, I want to get your reaction first to Caitlin's reporting. The White House no longer going to put out its own version, like its readout, right? Its way of shaping the narrative on these crucial calls with foreign leaders. Does it matter?
Yes, it matters. It means the president is not going to take the American people into his confidence, and the American people should know less about what's going on because apparently he doesn't trust the American people or trust the democratic process. So he can make private deals with other countries, or what he thinks are private deals, and it's no business of the American people. That's anti-democratic, and it's authoritarian.
Well, of course, you know, here's the thing. You know, when it comes to the summit as an example, right, Putin's been putting out his version bit by bit, right, saying Trump agreed to a referendum in eastern Ukraine and a Crimea and all sorts of things that are completely against U.S. policy. I mean, are you going to do anything about this, or it's the president's prerogative to put put out these summaries?
I don't know that we can force the president to put out the summary. We can criticize him for it, but the fact that we can hold hearings and ask the administration what was done, if Congress would be willing to confront the president, but under the Republican leadership, we're not holding hearings on anything intelligent. We're certainly not on anything to confront the president or his administration, whether it's on the child abuse at the borders or whether it's on the fact that the president humiliated himself and the United States at the summit, that he believed Putin's assurances over all our intelligence agencies about the Russians' interference in our elections, or the fact that the president is not doing anything to protect our next elections from an ongoing attack by the Russians. Congress is supine under the Republican leadership.
Obviously, you know, the latest we have, I believe it was from Chief Rogers, was you know, nothing. They haven't been given any authority by the president to go ahead and do anything about an attack on the elections. That's the latest statement we have. I mean, the Russians today said about this invitation that the president has issued, right? They acknowledge they've gotten it, right? He's invited us to Washington. Their comment was, "I think it'd be wise to let the dust settle, then we can discuss all these questions, now." I mean, why is Putin not jumping at this?
Because he humiliated the president, and now he's playing with him. Now he's just running a victory lap. It's insulting to the United States. And how could the president have announced that he was inviting Putin to the United States without getting an acceptance behind the scenes first.
I want to turn to the House Speaker Paul Ryan. You know, you obviously saw what he said today about Putin, right? He said he's not welcome in our halls because he's not an ally, right? Couldn't be more clear about it. He also spoke today about the White House's suggestion, right? Not just a suggestion, right? But they said that they are looking into the mechanisms to strip security clearance from former intelligence chiefs, including John Brennan and James Clapper, right? Others that they mentioned already don't have security chiefs. Let me play Ryan.
I think he's trolling people, honestly. I think some of these people have already lost their clearances. Some people keep their clearances.
Trolling? That's all it is? I'm sorry, Congressman. Can you still hear me?
Yes, I can now.
Okay, I'm sorry. So what Paul Ryan said, let me just read you what he said.
I heard what Ryan said.
You heard what he said. Okay, he said, I think he's trolling people. It sounded like he was making light of it. Do you agree with that analysis, just trolling?
No, this is punishing distinguished public servants who devoted their careers to serving the safety of the American people. It's punishing them for expressing their opinions. It's another attempt to say that we control all information and we don't want criticism. I think that is wrong and dangerous.
I also want to play what the Attorney General said today, Jeff Sessions. He was speaking to a crowd today, and I want to play for you what happened. This obviously is a reference to Hillary Clinton. Here it is.
Lock, all right. Well, so I heard that a long time over the last campaign.
You obviously know the Attorney General, right? Colleague of yours over on the Senate side for years. You oversee the Department of Justice, which he, of course, runs. And often he does so while the president threatens him with his job. Is what happened today appropriate? Will you do anything about it?
No, it's not appropriate. It was a missed opportunity. I mean, there are a bunch of kids. I think the audience is a bunch of kids. And it was a missed opportunity to educate them and to say, look, that was a partisan chant. And the fact is, she was charged with nothing. We know a crime was committed during the 2016 election, and that crime was committed by the Russians in attacking our elections and by various people in the Trump campaign by cooperating with them, and that's under investigation. That's a serious crime. And the next serious crime would be not to do anything to protect our current elections. And look what the House just did. The House Republicans just voted to zero out all funds for helping states protect their own election machinery. That is the risk of abetting criminal activity by the Russians trying to destroy confidence in our democracy. And this nonsense about lock her up ought to be relegated to a previous year. And let's talk about what we ought to be doing to protect our democratic institutions. We have a president who trashes the courts, trashes our police agencies, trashes every institution that might put any limit on his power and that might investigate what happened and might protect us in the future.